Bloodbath in the markets today, and this is just the beginning. The Toronto Stock Exchange closed today. They blamed it on a technical glitch, but it was probably done intentionally to stop the bleeding. Over $3 trillion were wiped out from the stock market in the last few days. The stock market has been plummeting in recent days. On Thursday, the Dow Jones Industrial Average lost nearly 1,200 points. This is the fastest collapse in stocks from record highs into correction since the Great Depression. History repeating itself. 1919 and 1929, all wrapped up into 2020. Kept telling you to get prepared and starting to panic now. White House to hold emergency press conference on market plunge. The S&P is at levels not seen since, wait for it, October 18, 2019. This emergency press conference just shows you how far we have gone down the shitter. The stock market has to go up no matter what a joke. What happened to candidate Trump? Is he going to call upon the Fed to take emergency action? Or maybe he'll abolish the Fed, outlaw usury, return to the gold standard and reinstate Glass-Steagall. Candidate Trump had it right in 2016 when he called it, a big fat overblown bubble that'll end bigly badly. There once was a time when the markets were a reflection of the actual economy and not overt manipulation. Functioning markets go both up and down. If the market wasn't in such a massive bubble state, there wouldn't be such a bloodbath. A 50% correction is what it will take to make the markets authentic again. Donnie made the mistake of hanging his hat on this overvalued bubble of a stock market. Now he is going to be wearing it. That's his only concern. Our national nightmare is just beginning. Welcome back to the Atlantis Report. Please take some time to subscribe to my two backup channels. I do upload videos there, too, on a daily basis. You'll find the links in the description box. Thank you. Dow falls 1,191 points, the most in history. The Dow has collapsed from a record high into correction in the space of just 6 days. As we detailed earlier, this is the fastest collapse from an all-time peak since 1928, just ahead of the Great Depression. Trump will try to calm things down. But the virus is going against him. The stock market Ponzi is not the whole economy. We need a healthy, smart society, and we can rebuild a bubbly market. Dead people tend to be a bigger problem than minus 2000. Everyone on my channel knows we were 10 years past a decent correction anyway. Don't panic about that. Welcome it. It's okay. Dow 2000 is a problem. Dow 20,000 is not a problem. This is a recognition that we have gone too far in terms of liquidity risk and credit risk, and that economic fundamentals have deteriorated. Just last week, the S&P 500 stock index was hitting record highs. Now it's in freefall. The markets are still selling off after hours. Dow just took out the 50.00% FIBI of December 18 lows. Across the board, companies have faced significant losses today, but tech companies have been hit particularly hard. Investors are attributing the losses to high bond yields. The higher rates on bonds could result in slowdowns in the technology industry and other sectors. Market participants have shifted investment from risky equities to safe haven assets like gold and government bonds. All three major stock indexes plunging. Investors are buying the dip, but each time they do, the Dow dips even further. Investors did the same thing in October of 1929. It is unclear how a rate cut from near zero to near zero is going to boost stocks and the economy. Or it will be from near zero to far negative with a bonus bail-in. Negative rates by Halloween. No tricks. Fed will nuke the market with liquidity all the way to their last dying bad breath. QE5 is coming to buy last 11 months. Your Social Security and 401k gone. And a virus is coming to get you. The Canadian TSX experienced a convenient system glitch at the end of the day. I remember 2008 glitches. Those coincidences always happen at the worst time. A lot of notional wealth based on assumptions and hopes, and other illusions are now evaporating like the dream you had as you awaken in the morning. The wealth people thought they had will be understood to be less real than their nighttime dreams. Negative rate bonds, high yield, and leveraged loan use the main potential victims. The role of passive funds can amplify any disruptive effects. It may not take on the appearance of the proverbial black swan, but the coronavirus epidemic can truly represent that grain of sand capable of blocking the gears of the engine of the markets, which until a few days ago was in apparently excellent health and was traveling at speeds never reached. According to the most pessimistic among economists and managers, the spread of the virus that started from China is, in fact, likely to be the pinpoint that causes the various bubbles to burst involuntarily created by the easy money that central banks have spilled all over the world for a decade now. A world turned upside down. The liquidity pumped at a high rate on the list's 15,000 billion in the last 10 years is, however, a double-edged sword, wanting to continue on the metaphor's thread is like a tide. It grows when the mood of investors is sky high, but it is ready to retreat very quickly when fear returns to dominate it, warns Tad Revell, head of fixed income investments of TCW, an independent Californian company that manages assets for $217 billion. And the coronavirus is obviously titled in all respects to instill fear among investors, to the point of being able to trigger a liquidity crisis that basically remains an aspect rooted in the DNA of the markets itself. In this case, attention instinctively goes to the reverse world of bonds, the one in which securities for thousands of billions travel at negative rates, the paradox of the 21st century according to which you pay to lend money to an issuer. If we narrow the field to government bonds only and exclude BTP, the reaction to the escalation of tension on the markets has actually turned into a hunt for the bund, whose 10-year yield has returned to minus 0.50%, treasuries, historic lows of 1.33%, and other government agencies perceived as a safe haven in the storm. And also, the overall value of the negative rate bonds recorded by the Bloomberg Barclays indices returned to rise over $14 trillion and aim towards the records of last summer. The raw of the dollar credit. Growth in dollar-denominated global credit markets since the financial crisis. The world of debt, however, is much more multifaceted and problematic, worth a total of $253,000 billion, 322% of world GDP, and the biggest problems are found elsewhere. For example, among the high-yield securities whose number has proliferated enormously precisely because of the ease of obtaining capital on the market, even by companies that are not always meritorious. But not only that, if only in the United States we add the dimensions of the aforementioned high-yield bonds to those of leveraged loans, the leveraged loans granted to companies and traded on the market almost as bonds, and to the private debt, which not even are exchanged, exceeding $3,000 billion, almost double the number of 2008. The problem, in this case, is that these markets do not shine for transparency. There are few, and decreasing, companies listed and therefore required to disseminate financial data on a regular and exhaustive basis. Opacity is certainly not an obstacle in the bullish cycles when buying everything without discrimination, but it can become so if risk aversion dominates, in these phases, Revell explains. Investors ask questions again, a gap is created information between those who sell and those who buy, and this generates illiquidity because the difference between the desired price and the one offered is too large and the transactions do not close. An additional complication in a similar scenario is represented by the proliferation of passive funds, ETF and not only, which automatically replicate the composition of an index. Indeed, their role is proactive when markets go up, but it becomes very dangerous when sales become indiscriminate and accentuate potential liquidity risks. The market has been artificially propped up for a long time, and now they've got an excuse to blame the crash on. It was rigged to be demolished. Truth is, they've been fleecing the American public with their usury scheme for over a century with the fake fiat they've been printing for decades, but the entire thing is a scam because their paper notes were backed by nothing. If your neighbor loaned you some worthless paper with interest, using your property as collateral, on the pretense that it represented a store of value and you found out that he scammed you the whole time, would you hand over your property to him? Further, what if you found out that he had been raiding your storehouse, i.e. treasury, for decades? Corona was implemented as a smokescreen by the banksters to not be blamed for this mess. First tried war with Iran, but somehow Trump did not want to make it. The economic fundamentals were eliminated. The government got involved, and all fundamentals went bye-bye. At least 20 years ago. Time to invest in things that matter. Like community, farming, gunsmithing, welding, building, steel working. It's time to get to work. These markets are just downright insanity. Stock brokers are jumping out of their one-story building offices. This market is nuts. Just a heads up. While the Venezuelan economy was melting down, their stock market was the best performing market in the world for like 6 straight years. Like Greenspan said, we will be sure there is enough money. We can't guarantee it will be worth anything, but there will be plenty of it. I really always thought they would pull the markets and then do bioweapons and quarantines. They did both at once, bungling their narratives huge too. I always thought they would drop something worse too, maybe something hemorrhagic. I guess they still have some time. The day of the rope is coming. They are completely mad. This was the Atlantis Report. Please like, share, subscribe. And please take some time to subscribe to my two backup channels, I do upload videos there too on a daily basis. You'll find the links in the description box. Thank you.